right? If I make a mistake in my latitude, maybe I type positive 20 instead of 10, or negative 40 instead of the correct latitude for Kenya. If I make a mistake in any latitude but get the longitude right, then I populate this line. And if I make a mistake in any longitude but get the latitude right, I get the horizontal line. So you should be able to look at any map of dirty data, and you know that all data are dirty, and you should be able to pick out these symptoms.
In fact, there's another more obscure thing that can be spotted if you just take a look for a while. Don't you think these points here, just south of Kenya, are very regularly separated? There's the same distance between these two points, and these two points, and these two points, and these two points, and these two points. Why? What that could possibly be? This is a pretty good question. Those points are likely to be low precision coordinates, low precision latitude. The latitude value of those points is surely recorded without a single decimal figure. This one over here might be latitude minus 10, and minus 11, and minus 12, and minus 13, but without any decimal figure. This is what low precision coordinates look like a uniform matrix. So, this representation, just seeing the map of the records, gives us a lot of information about the quality of these data. And also, we can imagine, or at least we can deduce to what extent can we be reliable? Can we rely on this information? What extent is it going to be useful for our purposes?
It's very easy just to essentially cut out the Kenyan records and ignore everything else. And that's kind of what you saw in the first map we showed you through the country-based portal. So the real job of cleaning is to take all of those messy things, the cross, the 0, 0, the wrong latitude or longitude, take those and one by one figure out what the problem is. Okay? So that's what we were talking about yesterday, with getting closer and closer to a clean data set.
That's still more important things. So this example here, this map, is if you use the right tools such as mapping, it reveals self-evident issues. But if these records outside the Kenya boundaries are clearly wrong, so we are sure we can remove them from our analysis if we want to stick to Kenya, and then work with the rest of the records that fall inside Kenya. But there are other issues, other problems with the records that might not be so easy to detect. Let's, for example, make another search. We will search now for the polar bear occurrences. Okay? The polar bear, as its name reflects, should only happen in the North Pole. Right?
So what you're seeing right there should be approximately its distribution.
Mm-hmm. These are, at least initially, good-looking records for polar bear. Now let's imagine we don't see the map. We just got the records from GPS without plotting the map. We make an ecological niche model. I'm not going to show you. But let's suppose we made the ecological niche model without first checking this information. We then got the map, the actual niche model, and, this one.
Well, that's a lot of men over there. Somebody will kill you.
But these two guys here, in the middle of the United States, which is quite dry, quite hot in summer.
Well, that's a perfect thing. What's, how, in what possible universe have we found?
Is this a coordinate issue? Is this a georeferencing issue? Is this any other kind of geospatial information self-evident issue? It might be, it might not be. The only way to know is to go to the original data, see if the original record has that information, if it has been a problem in the processing. So I searched for one of these two points, and this is what I found. This is the page, the overview page of a single record, which has all the information available, all the information that is available at a glance. So we will go to the geo, to the location part, see the data set information, taxonomy information, and the geospatial information. And we see that the coordinates here look right.
Extremely,
extremely precise. But if we look at the verbatim locality, look at that bear is in a zoo. So what's the point of bringing an animal that's captive, that's in a zoo, to an ecological niche modeling? It's clearly out of its natural environment. So what will happen if we bring this occurrence to an ecological niche model? The model would say that it's highly probable that we can find polar bears in the middle of Texas.
So what we've just illustrated for you are what I would call gross errors. Okay? These are errors that are very, very, very obvious. So, you could look at this map, not even knowing that this is a map of polar bear occurrences, and you're going to say, well, most of the occurrences are up here, why are there just a few here and then one in the middle of the ocean? Something's wrong. You don't even need to know that it's a polar bear. Those are really gross errors. But what would happen if this point really should be over here? That's a more fine scale error. Okay, or what if we had a point misplaced within Kenya in the earlier example? So it's not just a matter of catching these gross errors that kind of kick you in the face. It's a matter of going through your data very carefully, like what we saw yesterday, where we were seeing whether the point falls in the same district as the textual descriptor says that the point should be. So, again, these are just two quick examples designed to illustrate for you why you need to do this. They're obvious examples, they're nothing subtle, but it's just an illustration that even in the biggest data portal, data aggregator that is available today, this sort of messy data is out there, okay? It's part of life. The data set is clean. It could be cleaner, but this is why we're doing this course.
And we would like also to stress one thing out. I will go back to the Kenya example here. As I said before, this is a data cleaning issue, but it's also a data publishing issue. And the problem here is not GBIF's problem. GBIF has nothing to do with the content, with the ultimate quality and fitness for use of the record. This is not a GBIF fault. Because all GBIF does is gather the records and make them available to the largest number of people. These records here are like this in the original collections. So DBIT is not a data source, it's a network of data publishers. And so the ultimate owners and responsible for their records are owners themselves and publishers themselves. So it's their fault to have this dirty data. It's their responsibility to clean it up and to republish it once clean.
But we do try and help them a little.
They try a little. We will see in the next session in the yellow flag and things. They try. And in fact, they do a great job in detecting most of these kind of issues. And we will see why in the next error flag session.
Any questions just about this pair of examples? John?
I'm curious with the example that's up there right now. It seems odd to me that you have the distribution of latitudes that way without having longitudes. Do you have any idea why that is for this data set? It's a whole country.
We should. We should check a bit further why it's only a latitude issue and not a longitude issue. But we also found, and you can see that because it's on your flash drives, that something like this also happens with mammals from Kenya. And there you can see both axes. You can see vertical axis and then horizontal axis. So with mammals from Kenya, there's both the latitude and longitude issues, apart from the mirror image, which is common to both cases.
Do you know if all of those come from one data source?
That's one thing that would be my first guess. Especially the ones in the south, because there are two issues that happen simultaneously. The latitude transposition and the low precision data. So, a common rule here is what I like to call the collection behavior. That when something happens in many records from a collection, it's likely that it will happen to all the records from a collection, or at least that all the issues that happen that are similar might be due to one single collection. So all these, on the one hand, all these parts, all these, because there are more than one record, might be due to three different publishers. But we have to check, we can't assume anything, but that's a guess and a starting point to start looking for ways to clean that.
All of these are things that you should think about as you look at your data, okay? Because there's symptoms. Question, hold on.
I don't think it was.